What is going on YouTube? My name is Keg, and welcome back to another episode of BTD Battles. Now, in today's episode, let's see what we've got in the... Oh, I got a free spin. I think I do that every time, where I gotta go into battle arenas. I'm like, oh, there's a free spin there. I better do that. I just always forget that it's there. What can we get? Can we get... I would have taken 80, and I got 20 instead. Never mind. 20 medallions, I'll take it. Let's go into the battle arenas. Let's see what we've got today. We have got Bonanza, always my favorite. Love Bonanza. A bit of Random Trio. Ooh. Random Trio can be quite fun. And R3 Speed. I tell you what, let's start out with a Random Trio, and then I'll probably go into a Bonanza and see if we can go a bit of late game. Love a bit of late game. But hopefully, I don't think there's too many people in this playlist of... Random Trio, as we can tell, but sitting on the lookout. So hopefully we can find someone here, because I really wouldn't mind having a game of Random Trio. It's such a good game type, but you got to be so careful that you can actually pop chemos, and more specifically, you can pop something like chemo leads and chemo ceramics, because those two things, they will take you down super quick. So we're up against A-Hall 83. And we're going to play on cards. I'm happy with that map. And we've got the Ninja, the Super Monkey, and the Ice Monkey. That is an interesting combination. Quite reasonable. I'm okay with that. I will go with that. So we're going to start out with the Ninja. He is not the best way to start early game. However, out of the three towers that I have, I'm happy to start with him. So we're going to go with the Ninja. I've got to wait till round two before I can start sending Eco. So I might as well upgrade my Ninja a little bit. Because believe it or not, ninjas struggle with reds. They struggle with reds. As awesome as ninjas are, like a Blinchester ninja or Flash Bomb ninja or whatever, as awesome as they are, yeah, a low level ninja, he will struggle with reds. There is no doubt about that. As you can see, the reds are already starting to push past him. He is already starting to chase, which is crazy. Absolutely crazy. So I'm gonna throw down my tax. Keep going with a bit more ego, because at this point in time I'm not going to die to anything. He's sending blues, which is definitely not what you want to do. You definitely want to send the grouped reds this early on. The space blues, the ninja can take him out quite easily, but it's the grouped balloons that he's having problems with. So I think I want to get double shot on him, and then I'm going to start spamming out some grouped blues rather than the space blues. Keep getting our ego up to 300 eco already, which is okay. He's going space pinks again. Space balloons, not what you want to do against a ninja. You want the group balloons, because space pinks, I am taking them out, no problems at all. And the group balloons on his side aren't necessarily getting that far, but they're getting further than what the space pinks are on my side. So that's something to keep in mind. Also, with the greens coming out, he's starting to struggle a little bit. I would like to see him drop a few more towers, but maybe he doesn't have the economy. He doesn't have the money there. I'm not quite sure. He is starting to send out a few more blues. He stopped sending them out, so I will go another monkey. We're gonna go another monkey, another ninja. We'll put him there and get him the range and speed upgrade as well, because once yellows start pouring out, then we're gonna be in drama. So a few greens coming out. I think he's probably on about a similar amount of money that I am, probably a similar amount of ego that I am. We've pretty much got two towers the exact same. His other ninja's just slightly more upgraded than mine, and he is starting to spam out a few greens now. I'm not too worried. I will get sharp shurikens. A few of these greens are going to start taking out some of our attacks. Not a big deal. I'm going to save up just a little bit of cash here and then start spamming out some yellows. Here we go. Tick over for me, Eco. There we go. So I can keep on spamming out a few more yellows. So yellows are definitely going to be an issue. You can see that yellows have gotten a fair way on his side. So we're about 450 Eco now. I'm going to stop there. Get my other ninja upgraded. Oh, I'm starting to hurt him. He's down to 107 lives already. That's pretty good. That's not too bad. So I'm going to get my other ninja upgraded. So they're both at a 3-1 ninjas now, which is all right. Once the pinks start coming out though, that's going to be a whole different story. So we can get pinks next round. He is just spending his money like crazy. He is absolutely spending his money like crazy. And neither of us have any lead popping power. So I'm going to go a lead, two pinks, a lead, another pink. I know that I can sell one. No, I can't sell any of mine, actually. I was about to say I could sell one of the ninjas and get a Blue Jitsu. Oh, sorry, get a Flash Bomb Ninja, but I can't even do that. So we'll see how he responds. He's starting to send out leads against me. I'm going to get a ninja. upgrading like that. I need 2,750. I can sell him for 1,800. Give me another one. Come on. And we will get a Flash Bomb Ninja and then boost. And we should be completely fine. Whereas the leads are just going to walk straight through on his side. And A-hole 83 has been defeated. And my tax didn't even get used up. Happy with that. So that was a good game against A-hole. He doesn't really have that good a win ratio or medallions. But that's okay. So that's a random trio. There's only 170 players in that arena. So let's jump into a bonanza, my absolute favorite. And let's see if we can do an actual bit of proper late game. Because I've said that last few videos that I want to go late game and either I get rushed or I just sort of do a quick rush against my enemy. But I want to change it this time. We're against player with 59% ratio, 4,700 trophies, or medallions, I should say. Water Hazard. There's nothing wrong with the Water Hazard map, but I don't want to play it on this one because I want to go late game, of course, with the Super Monkeys. So I'm going to skip it. I'm going to hope that we get an all land map, not hot tub. Oh my god, that is not. Thank you. Thank you for skipping it, player. Hopefully we're an all land map. Snowfall. That's okay. We're pretty close. So there's a number of variants you can do for late game. I'm hoping that I'm going to get something I can put into a Super Monkey. So I'm going to go my Cannon, my Wizard, and my Super Monkey. I'm going to hope for something like an Ice Sour. Boomerang isn't going to make any alterations to my temples. So let's go, what do we got? Sniper. And that doesn't do any alterations to my temple either. So that sucks. But never mind. We have at least got our Cannon, our Wizard, and of course, our Super Monkey. So that will be good for making fairly good temples. All right, it's Bonanza. I totally forgot. I already forgot. He's going farms. So that's a good indication that he will probably do something like a ZOMG, big ZOMG rush or something like that around about round 21. I guess something like that. We haven't even seen any of his towers yet. So we'll just hang out for a bit, see what he puts down. Start building up an eco. So he's got ninjas. That's okay. The other late game alternative you can go instead of what I'm doing here with the wizards and the cannons is of course something like ninjas and balloon chippers. That's the other combo where the balloon chippers are really strong late game, like properly strong in late game. I'm just going to put that 0-0 wizard there just in case he starts rushing with anything. Balloon chippers are so good at late game, so good. And then if you can combine them with something like your ninjas, so it's slowing the balloons down, the ZOMGs down, and then also sucking them all in. Yeah, amazing late game towers. So let's get that wizard up to 2-2, get him to lightning. Yeah, or you can do what I'm doing. I wish I really got an ice tower or what's the other combo that can go into a temple? Ice tower, glue gunner, or a glue gunner. That way you can make really super strong temples and hopefully that will hold them all off. But I've found in my own personal testing that the balloon chippers are the way to go. They do anything that can slow down the balloons that late game, like round 130 onwards. Yeah, that's what's most important, not damage, because you just can't damage the balloons. They're so strong at that sort of level, at that late rounds, that it doesn't matter how much damage you put into them, you really need to start slowing them down. So this guy's got two ninjas down, having the boost. He probably really didn't need to, but I guess he's not worried about saving his boosts. He's got five farms down now, earning tons and tons of cash, earning significantly more cash than I am, that's for sure. And okay, he's starting to upgrade his farms. I thought he might put down a sixth one there just to make it all symmetrical and looking nice. But nah, he's selling his farms now, so I'm assuming that he's gonna get one of them up to a factory. I don't know why I'm still sending greens, because you can send reds and you can send yellows. So no, he's just upgraded all three farms to 3-0 rather than getting one of them up to a factory. I thought for sure he'd get one up to a factory, but he hasn't. There's his Balloon Jutsu Ninja, so he'll defend against all these yellows, even all the pinks, without any problems at all with the Balloon Jutsu Ninja. He really should be making another Balloon Jutsu Ninja out of the other one, but I guess he doesn't need to. So all I know so far, actually I should just get another wizard just there. All I know so far is that he has got ninjas and farms. I don't know what his other two towers are. And all he knows from me so far is that I have got wizards. So neither of us really have any idea what the other person's doing. I'm kind of shocked. He just got the more valuable banana upgrades on one of his farms. Look at that. His bananas are 120 and 180. So he got more valuable bananas before he even got a 4-tier farm. That's crazy. That's super rare that you see that. Let's get some more upgrades on my wizards. It's starting to get a bit long now. There's the factory. So we're at round 12. He has got one factory up, and ironically, I don't think it's the one with more valuable bananas. 1200, it is the one with more valuable bananas. Okay, so he got the upgrade on the factory. It was super weird to have that upgrade first before you get factory. That's very strange. Very, very strange. But anyway, on to round 14, three factories. He's gonna start having tons and tons and tons of cash. So I kind of want to test him out a little bit. Let's go some camo rainbows with a few zebras built in there. The reason why I went camo is because I don't want the glue gunner at the end there to kill him. And we're gonna keep on going with our pinks. It's got super monkey down. The glue gunner is not gonna be able to see those camos. He'll lose a few lives, but no big deal. Now we see he's got the ninja. He has got the glue gunner, super monkey, and farm. That's his four towers. So I think I'm quite happy. I'll just keep going up to 5,000 eco just because I love the round numbers. Why not? Let's get this guy up to Dragon's Breath and him up to Dragon's Breath. Feeling a little bit nervous, that's for sure. There's 5,000 eco. Let's get him up to Dragon's Breath as well. So we have three at Dragon's Breath. And I think I'm just going to put one super monkey in the middle, roughly there. And we're going to get range and stuff on him. And I'm just going to upgrade him a little bit so that he can help out against... Oh, I shouldn't have got that. I should have just went straight to the $9,000 upgrade, but never mind. So that he can help out against anything crazy that comes through. If this guy's going to send some early Moabs or he's going to start spamming out some ZOMGs, what can he send right now? He can't send anything right now, so he's definitely saving up a fair bit. If he starts sending out ZOMGs, I'm certainly not going to be able to do anything about it. Grouped ZOMGs, I just won't be able to take down. My towers simply are not going to be strong enough to take down grouped ZOMGs. There's not a whole lot I can do about that. So, which I imagine he's going to at round 21, 24, whenever they're available, I can't remember. Just because, yeah, he has so much money. Look at all those 1800s that he's ticking, not to mention he's got three monkey banks. So he's getting 5,000 off them every couple of rounds. Yeah, it's a lot of money. However, having said that, I am up to almost 7,000 eco. Got 30,000 in the bank as well, which is awesome. Here come a few leads. And we're at 7,000 eco now. Starting to get very slightly nervous, so I'm going to put my first super monkey up here in the corner. Get the sun god upgrade on him. And then the next one we need to do will be about here. I'm going to start putting down some sun gods so that I am ready for something. You know, if he starts sending out stuff, at least I've got something there. Now, I cannot put one there and have one in the corner. So I think I will... If I put one there, I can put one here-ish. And then I can put, like, another one here-ish. I'm not really gaining anything. Because I could have one there... One about there, yeah, okay. So I'm gonna put this one right. Oh, can I put him? No, wow, look at that. You can only put him there. Is that because of the bin? There's just something there. Anyway, 1, 2, 3. Okay, he just got his first temple. That's okay by me. Him having a temple, that means he's spending his money. That is awesome. Let's put that one there. 1, 2, 3. And let's go about there and there. So that's okay. 1, 2, and 3. Can't quite get it yet. So I'm feeling a little bit better now. We do have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 temples. No, sorry, not temples. We have that many sun gods. Now, I didn't actually look to see if he put the glue gunner into those temples. Him saying destroy is not good. That's not a good sign. I think that means that around 24, he's going to start spamming out some stuff. Probably going to start spamming out quite a lot of stuff. He's got two temples now. Guys, to show how much extra money he has got than I do, because he is able to afford two temples and I can't even afford one. Crazy. All right, we're up over 8,000 eco now. My next super monkey, I think I'm gonna have to sell him and put another one there, because if I put one there, it's gonna override. Yeah, okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna sell that one, put this guy there. 1, 2, 3. We can put another one right there. That means I can probably fit one just here. Like that. Yeah, that's nice. That'll fit really well there. 1, 2, 3. Why not? Let's keep going with a little bit of eco. These glue gunners are so strong. I love glue gunners. They are literally so strong. People don't get how super awesome a glue gunner is. So we're going to put that one there. 1, 2, 3. And I think our very last one will go somewhere here, because it doesn't matter if I put it... Can I fit it there? No. Okay, if I put it about... I can't even fit it there. So if I put it about there, I'm still not going to be able to fit one there or there or there. So it doesn't really matter where it goes. 1, 2, 3. All right. I need to get my eco up a bit. I need it to be at least 15,000 on this eco before I start making all these temples. Hopefully he doesn't really realize that I'm trying to go as late game as I possibly can, because right now he could just send out mass ZOMGs and absolutely kill me. Looks like he's spending heaps of his money though, getting all his upgrades done on all his super monkeys, so I'm happy to see about that. Yeah, I'm happy to see that he's doing that and he ain't rushing me. I do need to be a little bit careful though, because the only thing I've got to detect Gamo is of course my 3 mages. That's literally it. That's all I've got. Nothing else can see camo at the moment. I wonder how the snipers would go. You know, I really like snipers, but I don't know if they are that good at taking out ZOMGs and stuff. I mean, yes, they can slow down Moab class balloons, but I don't know if they're that good. I don't know. We'll see how we go at the end of this one. So we're up to 10,700 eco now, which is excellent. Up over 100,000. You might be thinking, right, you can build a temple now. Build a temple. But I can't, because I need to fill the temple with 4 wizards and probably 6 cannons before I can actually make it into a proper temple. And of course, a Tech Terra, because I need 30,000 from wizards, 30,000 from cannons, and 30,000 from any other tower. If I had ice or glue, I'd also need 30,000 from those towers to make my temples even stronger. So I'm pretty happy about this late game. I'm fairly comfortable right now that he's not going to spam me with any sort of ZOMG rush right now. He wants to go late game too, which is excellent. And I feel like my temples will be stronger than his temples. Not to mention the fact that I've already got 3 down the bottom, across the bottom, and he's only got 2. And everywhere else he's spamming down what I think is going to be Tech Terrors. So I feel okay about this. I'm going to put down just a couple more wizards. I am just slightly concerned. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Slightly concerned about the chemo popping power right now of my team, because it's literally crap. It's so bad. And I will actually get these up to phoenixes, because I need them to be phoenixes anyway to go into my temples. So I'm okay with them being phoenixes. Continuing to absolutely smash out the eco. Whoa, that was a lot of stuff that came through those sun gods. Continuing to absolutely smash out this eco. Doing really good. We are at 13,600. I'm going to stop it there just for the sake that I'm getting there. So, we need $30,000 worth of wizards. Wow, look how far over I can put that wizard in the top right. That is awesome. So, let's start with the intention magic. That's 300. Lightning Bolt brings up to 1,500. Fireball brings up to 1,800. Monkey Sense brings up to 2,100. Dragon's Breath brings it up to 23, and then 5,300. And then 4,000 on top of that is 9,300. I, of course, need 30,000. If I got 3 of them, that is not 30,000, so I need 4. So we need to put down 4. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. And of course, they all need to be within range of my... 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Of my sun god up there. And 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. Now let's check out the range of my sun god. Ooh. That's not good. I may not have enough range to fit all this in. Let's go. Ooh, look at that. That fits really good. Alright, so we need... I don't know what's better. I think it's the right-hand side. So starting on the right-hand side, 400. That's 800. That's 1700. And of course, it's 39. I'm just watching these mods. 39. What did I say? 1700. That's 1900. 4900. 5100. And 5400. 5400 if I go that way. And if I go the other way, 200, 500, so it's 5400 that way, so that's 500, 1300, 5300 already. Okay, so it's better going to the left. So I have no idea if I need to sell that one, but I'm going to do it anyway. So 200, 500, 1300, 5300, And then 6,100 and 6,500. 6,500, I need 5 of them to make up 30,000. And I think I'm going to need to increase the range on this. So let's go... which way was it? That way? 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. If I have a look at this now, I need to get super range. Will it eat the other two? Oh, I hope it doesn't eat that super monkey. I think it will, though. I think it will. Anyway. Let's keep... Wow, that packs in beautifully. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Let's go 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, 3, 4, 1, 2. 1, 2, 4, 5. Okay, so now I need to put in $30,000 worth of a Tech Terror. Which, can I please put it in there? Holy Jesus. Does it actually fit there? I need to check. Yes, it does. Okay. And there's $30,000 of that. Let's make this first temple with the wizards, with the missile launchers, with $30,000. And let's see if it eats my other super monkey there in the middle. It didn't. Nice. Got to be okay with that. Okay. Might as well smash out a little bit of ego because I haven't done any of that yet. And I think the next thing I'll do is get the other one up here. So let's make this a little bit quicker than we did last time because now we know how many. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. And we've got a little bit more room up here too, so I don't need to be as careful. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Did I actually get that other one upgraded? I didn't. Okay, so that's 4 of that. I need 5 cannons. Cannot fit anything in the top left. That sucks. That really sucks. Never mind. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Sorry for counting, but it's how I keep track of what I'm doing. Across, down, up. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. I can't see how many that is. I think it's 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 I've got there, which is perfect. 1, 2, 3, get that one done. Okay, he's got everything in range. Let's get him up to a temple, get the range upgrade, and we're killing it. Let's get a little bit more eco. Might as well get 15,000 while we're here. He has got so many Tech Terrors there in the middle, which are certainly going to help him out, I'll say that much. They're certainly not a bad tower to have. Now, if you look at the difference between his temples and my temples, my temples have a missile shooting out, and they have something else. They have a whirlwind coming out. His don't have that. His have no missiles, no whirlwinds. So that's how you can tell the difference if someone's temple has been upgraded. Let's go right to 15,008. Whoops, I just got a mention wrong. That's okay. Let's put down this other temple. Let's get him upgraded. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Keep going with these. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 3. I need 4. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, let's put some cannons down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. That's 3 cannons. This is number 4. Let's pop all these phoenixes because why not? Oh, look at that. Nice. And no lag whatsoever. He must be playing on PC, which is awesome. Thank you very much, my friend. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in there. Whoops. What's happening with my super monkey? And a Tech Terror for him. And another temple. Do it. That's my third super strong temple up. We'll celebrate with a little bit of ego, because why not? You can see, actually, if you have a look at the naturals coming out, my 3 temples are taking it down faster than all his Tech Terrors are. If you watch that carefully. Okay, so this one already has 2 wizards within range. So we only need another 2. Wow, that overlaps like crazy. Oh, I didn't. I thought I just stuffed that up, but I didn't. Let's go 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. And we'll get some cannons in here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. This will be a good challenge. Our very first ZRMG coming out. We'll see how far it gets on my side compared to his side. And let's go a few more. Come on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Pop all these phoenixes just because I have them there, and the ZRMG is getting way further than what I would like. He has already popped his. He has already popped his, so that's a bit of a big deal. Mine is still not popped. Are they serious? Alright, I'm going to put down a Tech Terror right here. Use the ability. Pop all this down, because that is getting way further than it possibly should. Way further than it should. I need to try and see... Where's this? There it is there. Okay, where's the range? Oh my god. I think I can put it down here and it's still within range. No, there we go. Okay. Like that. He has got everything in range. He's got 1, 2, 3, 4 cannons in range, I think. Might be 5, but I'm just going to put another one down here just in case. Let's get him up to a temple. God, these are getting way further than they should. Like that. Use that ability to kill them. They're getting heaps further than what I thought they would. Man, this is crazy. All right, I'm going to start building a few Tech Terrors up here. And we'll use that ability. Use my Phoenixes. This is getting heaps further than what I thought it would actually get. Can I fit snipers in here? Please tell me. Yes, I can. I totally can. I'm going to boost this because it's really, really scaring me. Super scaring me. 1, 2, 1, 2. I think it's deadly precision. I think. Yes, it is. And then cripple Moab. Cool. And we're going to put him on strong. Nice. And you can see that he's slowing down that Moab, which is awesome. That ZMG, I should say. Not the Moab. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Put him on strong. Nice, he's making it go so slow. That is so OP. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Oh, I didn't put him on strong. Put him on strong. Yeah, that is helping out heaps. That is helping out heaps more than what I thought it would. Can I get another sniper up here? Oh, wow, I can. Look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Nice. It's a little bit blank up the start here, so I'm going to keep putting down some more Tech Terrors. I don't want to put that down. Yeah, whilst there's nothing coming out, I'm going to keep going with the Tech Terrors up the top here because you just can't see anything. It's craziness. You cannot see a single thing. Can I speak properly? Apparently I can't. You cannot see a single thing up the top here once everything starts to get through. Okay, so now that I've got snipers down, it's actually not too bad. These things are getting stopped like crazy. Okay, I can fit a Tech Terror in here. So that's what I'm going to do. Like that. Okay, I'm feeling a little bit more comfortable now that I have a few more Tech Terrors. Let's see if I can fit another Tech Terror. I can't. So let's keep going there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Man, Tech Terrors are huge. 1, 2, 3, 4. No, I don't want that one. Accidentally clicking on the sniper. Can't fit him in. Goes about there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right, I can't fit any other Super Monkeys here, so I'm going to go more Cripple Moab snipers, which are super cool, I would like to add. Righty, I am down to 130,000. So what do you do when you're down on money? You keep going with more ego. Of course that's what you do. And you keep placing... Oh, I can fit an entire row, I think, of Tech Terrors in there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. It did absolutely nothing against that ZMG. That is excellent. That is always wonderful to see 13 Tech Terror abilities do nothing to that ZMG. Victory! And it got through on his side. What got through on his side? I wasn't even looking. He was defending so well. There's no way. How did anything get through? Oh my god, I'm going to have to go back and look at the replay. I'm going to give him a well done as well. Good. Oh, he left too soon. But good game, player, whoever you are out there. That was pretty epic. I didn't quite go as late game as I want. I didn't get all my temples down, but I still got like 16,000 eco, a number of temples down, heaps of Tech Terrors down, heaps of Cripple Moab snipers, which is what I love. I love going late game. So if you ever see me in BTD Battles, guys, always remember, I absolutely love going late game. So if I see you going late game, I'm going to go late game as well. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed that episode. All we got was one game of Random Trio and one game of Bonanza, but the Bonanza was a late game, and we all love that. So make sure you check out all the other videos on my channel, guys. I've got heaps of other videos, BTD Battle, Super Monkey, we've got Bloons Monkey City, a bit of Battlefield, heaps and heaps of videos up on my channel, so go and check them all out. Subscribe to the channel as well. I would love you forever if you subscribe up. Like the video if you like the video. And as always, guys, we'll see you in the next one.